Very good morning, my dear friends. A hearty welcome to my YouTube channel, Dr. M.H. Annaya Academy, and myself, Professor M.H. Annaya. Friends, in today's video, we are going to learn about the centroids of plane surfaces or plane figures. So basically, every engineer should know what is the centroid, what center of gravity is, and what is the difference between these two. Because generally in the examination they ask you distinguish between centroid and center of gravity. Friends, centroid is the center of mass of a plane surface. It could be a rectangular thin surface, a circular or semicircular or trapezoidal or triangular. So it can have any of these shapes. So the point where the full mass is concentrated for that particular surface is called a centroid. Whereas center of gravity refers to the center of mass of solids. When I say solid, it could be a prism, a cube, a cone, a cylinder, a pyramid, and so on and so forth. So in today's session, I am going to teach you how to locate the centroid of regular figures. The regular figures, when I say, I mean figures such as square, rectangle, semicircle, circle, quarter circle, then you have got this isosceles triangular, triangle, and then right angle, triangle, and so on. Friends, it's a very simple chapter, and basically if you know how to locate the centroids of all these, then you will be able to solve any problem either on a composite lamina or a lamina where some surface of that is removed. So friends, here let me start with this square. So I got a square plate, thin square lamina, and it has got dimension of 40 millimeter each. Now I have to locate the centroid of this. So friends, for figures like the square and rectangle, it is very easy to locate the centroid. For a square, if I am starting with, see, join the diagonals of these. So if you join these two diagonals, they meet at a common point, which I represent as G, that is the centroid of that. Friends, here, if I want to locate, or if I want to state at what distance G is from the vertical and axis and the vertical horizontal axis, I will take this point as the reference or the origin. Friends, you can see very well that this G is at a distance of this much, that is to say half of 40, that is 20 mm. So I will write down the x component here as 20, that is x component. And y distance, again this is 40 by 2, 20. So we can say that for this particular square plate, when I take x and y axis along its vertical and bottom edges, G, the centroid, lies at a distance of 20 millimeter from O and 20 millimeter upward along the vertical axis. Friends, in the same problem, if they ask you to find out the centroid with reference to the x and y axis, say it is passing through like this. Friends, again, it is very simple. To get the centroid, you will have to join these two diagonals, and then this point will give you G, the center. It will not change the position, but with reference to this origin and x and y axis, we have to write down, see here, all the y distances are measured from the x axis and the x distance from the y axis. Since the G is lying on the y axis, and you can say x axis distance is 0, comma y axis distance is this 20. So with reference to the new x and y axis, when you take up like this with O as the origin, the coordinates of this are x bar is 0 and y bar is 20. Friends, same procedure we follow for a rectangle also. Suppose if I want to locate the centroid of this rectangle, which has got dimension 60 by 40. So as usual, join the diagonals of these. So they meet at a common point O, or you can say G. We'll call the centroid as G in all the problem. Friends, if I take O as the origin here, the bottom of the plate as x-axis, the vertical side as the y-axis, then friends, you know very well, the centroid of this we can show by this. So here, I want the x-coordinate, that is the x-bar, is this much. This is 60 divided by 2. So this is going to be 30. And what about this distance along the y-axis? It is this height, which is exactly half of this height. So I will write down this as 20. So the centroid lies at a distance of 30 millimeter from the y-axis and 20 millimeter from the x-axis. This is how we locate with reference to O. But the same rectangle 60 by 40, if they ask you to locate the centroid G with reference to this origin O, so O is here, OX and OY are the two mutually perpendicular directions. Friends, here you can say similar to our square here, the G is here, and here since this center of gravity, centroid lies on Y axis, I will take this as O. X distance is 0, whereas Y distance is 40 by 2. So that is 20 mm. So G lies at the same location, but when you measure the distances, it all depends on the origin and the plane, the reference where you are taking. Friends, let us move on to the third, a triangle, which is a right angle triangle here, friends. It has got the dimension B and H. Friends, when you take this triangle in this position, this is the base and this is the height. Here the angle is 90. The dimensions are B and H. So sometimes they'll also ask you to derive these formulae that we'll take up in later on. So now here, this is G. Friends, this G for this X and Y axis is given by the formula. How does it? So he says the dimension nearer to the base is this. So this height is H by 3, means the distance along the Y axis is H by 3, total H by 3. So obviously from this sharp corner, it is going to be 2H by 3. This is from this side, it is 2H by 3, but I want from here, this is H by 3. Similarly, friends, if you want to find out the X coordinate here, this is going to be again this total dimension divided by 3. So this is going to be B by 3. So they will give you the actual values of B and H. So you will be able to. So this is going to appear very closer to the 90 degree. This is again B by 3. This is H by 3. So this is with reference to the X and Y axis shown here. For the same triangle, right angle triangle, if you have a figure like this, how to locate the centroid? Friends, it is the same procedure. I have got this G here. Then only thing is, while measuring the distance, say from here if you want to measure, this I told you, this total distance divided by 2/3, that is 2/3 of this. So this is going to be here 2/3 of, or from here it is 2B by 3, means 2/3 this height. Or if you want this distance, it is 1/3 that height, 1/3 the height. Similarly, friends, here I am measuring the vertical distance. It does not change because it remains on the same line. So this height is going to be H by 3, the height by 3. This is H by 3 from here. Okay. Friends, coming to the trapezium. Friends, here this trapezium can be split into two triangles, right angle triangles and a rectangle depending on the dimension. Friends, here the centroid is located here, which I call it as G, and that is given by the formula. See here, this is symmetrical about this axis. This is B by 2. I'll write down with reference to this. this is b by 2 is the x distance, and the height is given by the formula, or the y axis, y bar is given by the formula h by 3 b plus 2a divided by b plus a is the formula, because in the examination or in the test you cannot remember all these formula, so you cannot derive all this, so you have to remember this. So the coordinates of this x is b by 2 and y value or y bar is so much. Similarly, friends, if you have again a circle, so let's move on to the circle. Here friends, in the circle, you know, the center of mass or centroid lies at G, the point of intersection of these two diagonal or the diameters are exactly the center of the circle. So if we take this as the y axis and this as the x axis, so x is 0, y is 0. Suppose for the same problem, if you take this y axis here and the x axis here, so what happens, x value will be there, that is radius, r, y is equal to 0. So friends, similarly, if you have what is semicircle, and if you want to locate the centroid of that, this is given by the formula. From the diameter, it will be at a height of this 4r by 3 pi. 4r by 3 pi is the formula used to calculate the location of this. So if it is y axis here and this is x axis, the x distance is 0, y distance along the y, it is 4r by 3 pi. And once you know the value of radius of the semicircle, you will be able to calculate. Now, finally coming to this quarter circle, also friends, this lies from this straight edge, this is the center of the quarter circle, and G lies here, and remember, in both the cases, the G will be at equal distance from this corner. So this is 4r by 3 pi, and this is also 4r by 3 pi. So here G will be 4r by 3 pi, the x component or x bar, comma 4r by 3 pi, where r is the radius of that quarter circle. Friends, and finally you will have one or two more diagrams, such as an isosceles triangle. Suppose friends, you have got an isosceles triangle of base B and height H, and if you are interested to find out the centroid of this, you know friends very well, this is symmetrical about this vertical line through this, and the height of this is again given by this height by 3, h by 3. So the same rule holds good even for an equilateral triangle wherein the centroid lies along the vertical drawn through this corner say C, and at a height of, from here this is going to be h by 3, where h is the height, the vertical height measured from the base of the triangle. Friends, in this chapter, centroids of plane surfaces or plane figures, you are supposed to remember all these formulae. So once you remember all these formulae, and you will be able to locate the centroids of individual figures or of the composite figures made of this individual. It could be a problem wherein you are going to combine this with a semicircle here, or a rectangle with a semicircle here, or a square with a triangle on any of these four sides, and so on and so forth. Friends, I thank you all for watching my YouTube video. And if you are not subscribed to my channel, Dr. M.H. Annaya Academy, do subscribe to this channel. Help me to grow this channel, and I will help you to grow in return. So share the information with all your friends. Have a wonderful day. This is Dr. M.H. Annaya signing off.